This movie on care and calibration of tonometers is divided into two parts. The first part deals with the general care and the basic principles of care and calibration of various types of tonometers. The second part gives the technical details of how you can rectify calibration errors of your own Goldmann Applanation Tonometer. First, we shall try to understand the general principles of care and cleaning of tonometers. Then we shall like to know which are the disinfectants used for common tonometers, followed by a focus on specific requirements of each tonometer. A soft tissue impregnated with mild detergent may be used to clean body and plastic parts of any tonometer. A firm hand should be used for this wiping process. For cleaning of the screens of tonometers, a soft tissue should be used. Make sure that one surface of tissue is used only once. A blower brush may be used to remove dust from crevices and other areas which have difficult access for tissue wipe. After a day's use, storage should be done in dust-free environment with all the separable parts separated. Also ensure that the instrument has been cleaned and dried before storage. All disinfectants have some or the other problem related to them. Therefore, some of the tonometers have been made compatible with the use of disposable sleeves or even disposable prisms, making it possible to altogether avoid using disinfectants. However, cost remains an issue in these cases. Commonly used disinfectants include Pentasoft, hydrogen peroxide, household bleach, isopropyl alcohol, ether or hibitane. Some manufacturers recommend the use of their proprietary agents for disinfection. The most important factors include sufficient contact period, thorough removal of chemical, and making it dry before the next use or storage. Certain precautions should be taken at the time of disinfection, like avoid using corrosive agents, immersing in the fluid for long, and using high temperature. Obviously, only the concerned parts and not the whole instrument requires disinfection. Schur's tonometer is still in use because of its simplicity, low cost, versatility, and easy calibration. Zero error should be checked before every use. For cleaning in between cases, its foot plate should be cleaned with a chemical disinfectant, which should be wiped thoroughly before touching it to the cornea of patient. Although most of the disinfectants discussed earlier may be used, my personal preference is ether, as it evaporates very fast, minimizing chances of accidental chemical injury to cornea. Barrel of Schur's tonometer should be cleaned with distilled water and the brush provided with the instrument before starting its use in the morning, before long-term storage, or in case plunger gets stuck. Goldmann and Perkins tonometer share the same prism. The tip of prism should be cleaned before every use. However, disinfection is indicated before its first use, before long-term storage, or in case of use in a possibly infected patient. However, unused prism can be stored for indefinite period. Before a day's use, one should check the margins of prism for any scratches or sharp edges. For cleaning in between cases, many chemicals have been recommended, but please follow the contact period norm. In my personal experience, I find cleaning the mounted tip with a sterile eye pad made wet with freshly opened distilled water as safe and effective. It should be dried by touching dry part of the same pad to avoid thick mires and dilution of the dye. For the disinfection of Goldmann prism, remove prism from the holder, clean thoroughly, do disinfection for 10 minutes, rinse thoroughly and then dry with a soft tissue before storing it dry. Calibration check may be done every 1 to 6 months depending on the age of the instrument. It is done at knob position 0, 2 and 6. Precise setting of the mark is absolutely essential for proper calibration check. Although the manufacturers recommend calibration accuracy of 0.5, most of the literature opines that calibration accuracy of 1 mm mercury for position 0 and 2 and 2 mm of mercury for position 6 is acceptable. Perkins should be stored in dust-free environment like all other tonometers. However, disposable prism may be used. In general, these tonometers need to be sent to manufacturer for calibration. However, in-house calibration of Goldmann tonometer can be learned as shown in second half of this movie. Non-contact tonometers need simple cleaning as shown in the early part of the movie. However, sensor is very sensitive to dust and needs daily cleaning with a soft tissue but a firm hand. Tonopen uses disposable sleeve and hence requires no disinfection. In the older model called Tonopen XL, calibration is required before every use by pressing a button. However, the newer model called Avia does not require calibration. Avoiding dust is very important because this is an electronic gadget. It stops giving readings if dust enters the equipment. Pascal's dynamic contour tonometer uses disposable sleeve. In case of errors, factory calibration is usually recommended. Ocular response analyzer behaves just like non-contact tonometer. Rebound tonometer is also company calibrated and has a disposable probe that touches the cornea. However, probe base requires cleaning, which is done by removing it from the tonometer and injecting alcohol through the probe base with a syringe. Before mounting tube back into the tonometer, make sure that the tube has dried properly. At the end, I would like to say that before handling any equipment, understand it well by reading its manual and do not use the shortcut of just looking at the catalog. Now enjoy learning the in-house calibration of your own Goldmann Applanation Tonometer in the next part of movie.
The first step is to check and ensure that the table of the slit lamp on which the tonometer is mounted is horizontal. This is done using a spirit level. The next step is to ensure that the zero reading of the rotating drum has no backlash. When it is set in minus 0.05 position, the feeler arm should move towards you. And when the drum setting is plus 0.05, the feeler arm should move away from you. We'll be right back. If it doesn't, open the bottom plate and by using a screwdriver, adjust the screw there, and by trial and error, this can be achieved. Then check the measuring drum setting at 2. For this, use the control weight rod and set it for 2. Insert the rod in the tonometer and check at plus 1.95. The feeler arm should move towards you, and at plus 2.05, it should move away from you. If it doesn't, open the top plate by using a 5mm Allen key, turn the screw there till it is achieved by trial and error. same for plastic setting of the revolving knob.
At last, I thank Dr. Krishnadas and Dr. Srinivasan for accepting to associate with me in the production of this movie. I acknowledge the dedication and skill of Shri Puran Chandran, who has demonstrated the finest details of Goldmann Applanation Tonometry. I also acknowledge the support of Dr. Parakriti in the production of the movie and also for giving her voice in the second half of this film. Thank you very much.